So, OK, and then this will be a question for everyone, so you can all have a chance to think, but do you remember the first time you saw a restaurant or a bar or even a chef where you just thought, this is a game changer?
The one in the north of England that blew me away was Machinair.
Ah.
And that was almost, I think, bang on 20 years ago. And a lot of people don't realise that the guy cooking there was Jason Atherton, who's now one of the most lauded, heavily Michelin-starred chefs in the entire world. He's got restaurants all over the place. You look back at that business now, and it had this insane space-age design. It was all kind of mint green on one floor and all orange on another floor. And you read the menu from 20 years ago, every dish reads like something you'd happily order tomorrow. It was unbelievable. And I think it's like a good album or anything else. If it stands up 20 years later and still seems fresh, then you know that they've nailed something quite special. And I think that was an unbelievable place for its time.
Places like that don't come along very often, do they?
They do not.
That's the thing. Joycelyn, what about you? What do you...
My moment of this is what I want it to be like was Balthazar in New York. The Raw Bar and the oyster selection there was incredible, but more than that, the service that was delivered with it, and the staff were so interactive, full of banter, loads of chat, but the moment you asked a question, bang, know absolutely everything about the product. So fun, informal, but you know, brilliant quality, and just somewhere you would go more than once a week because you wanted to be there and you felt like you were at home in there. It's great.
Did you manage to get there more than once a week? I'd have been impressed.
No, but every time I go to New York, I always go.
Maya, what do you remember?
I think it was a trip in India when I was younger. My mum and dad used to send me every year to try and get the culture and not be fully British.
So you don't forget it, yeah. So, roast dinner, what's that?
Exactly. Out. So it was my dad's friend that I used to go visit in Ahmedabad, and his son was like, you know, for me, he was just an absolute legend. He knew everyone in Ahmedabad, took me around on his motorbike, the coolest kid, and he took me to the street food market in Ahmedabad. And I remember it was literally the modern, you know, interpretation of market halls with Mackie Mayer, and it was in this one venue, and the food was just absolutely stunning. There was just like the smells, flavours, aromas, and it was sort of like, you know what I mean? This casual eating atmosphere is what it's all about. Yeah. I feel like that was probably a bit of a moment in terms of food and drink for me.
And Marko, what about you? Moment, place, chef in the last 20 years?
Well, one place that inspired Bundobust particularly was a place in London called Polpo. Just chilled service, the vibe was amazing, the food was great, but you had waiters wearing t-shirts and had loads of chat. Before then it was like restaurants were pretty formal, and I think Russell Norman kind of made it more relaxed with, you know, amazing service. Great music playlists as well.
Which is important, isn't it?
Yeah, the
and
vibe.
That's important to you as well, Adam. You like your music playlist to be right, don't you?
Yeah. It's got to set the tone, hasn't it?
Yeah, so I think it's a hero of mine, I guess.
Martin?
I'm going to talk about a great rock and roll bar that was probably the inspiration for many other amazing cocktail bars in the country. And that was back in the day when I was growing up, was Mojo's, a little back street in Leeds, and that no one else was around. And I think for them to have that inspiration to open there, not on a circuit, away from everybody else, and to be run by the guys who owned it, they're behind the bar, they drink with you, they dance with you, they party with you. And I think in terms of what we're all about, hospitality and giving people a fantastic night out, I think they were probably the icons, really, who trailblazers for the industry.
Adam, what about you, mate?
What really made me realise where I want to go with it nowadays was when I ate at the Clove Club. Because I think, and talking there, what I'm hearing is what I see of the industry now. It was almost stifled in the past, like around this period here with the guides, 2000. It was stifled by what people expected things should be like when you go out. Whereas what you see now is everybody with their own experiences realising what they actually enjoy. We are what we are as a restaurant. We have our setting in the room and things like that, and it's history. But we're in the middle of Manchester, in the north, and we know where the bulk of our custom comes from. So I'm trying to create an environment where that market can just have a nice time so that they're in a good mood when they eat my food, because that's the main thing. If they're not in a good place when they're getting the food, your food, you might as well not bother, you know.